Namaskar everyone, my name is Navin Yadav and I am Faculty of Physics at Rawat Public School. Now in this video we will learn a topic of chapter number 4, that is magnetic effect of electric current. Okay, and the name of the topic is magnetic field at a center of circular current loop. Okay, so I am writing, that is magnetic field due to a circular current loop, and where we need to find out, that is at center. Okay, so before going in detail into the derivation, let us understand the diagram. So let's suppose this is a circular current loop, because of which we need to find out magnetic field, and at the center we need to calculate. Let's suppose this is the center of this circular loop. Okay, and the radius of this loop is, let's say it is R, and a amount of current is flowing into this circular loop, and that amount is I. Whichever current is entering has to leave the loop. Okay, so I current is entering into this loop. Okay, so this is the diagram that we have to use, and we need to use Biot-Savart law. Okay, what this Biot-Savart law says? Biot-Savart law says that dB is equals to mu naught upon 4 pi idl sin theta divided by r square. Okay, this is Biot-Savart law, or we can write down this in vector form as well. That is mu naught upon 4 pi idl r divided by r cube. Okay, so in this is the Biot-Savart law in the vector form. Okay, we need to use the previous one only, so let us not go for this. Now this point, that is this center, will subtend an angle 90 degree at all the points of this current carrying element. If this current carrying element is at this point, okay, then it will subtend a 90 degree angle. If this current carrying element is here, then it will definitely substitute 90 degree angle. Let's suppose this point is here, then it will subtend a 90 degree angle. And at any of the point, okay, this center will always subtend a 90 degree angle on the surface. Okay, so here the angle is, that is sin theta will becomes 1, because theta is here 90 degrees. So we can write down this expression, this magnetic field dB is equals to mu naught upon 4 pi I dl divided by r square only. Okay, this is the magnetic field and the angle here is 90 degrees. Okay, now we need to calculate, and this is a very small magnetic field. We need to calculate entire magnetic field. So what we'll do? We will integrate this. Okay, so dB integration is B. Here mu naught upon 4 pi I and R square. All these are constant, only we need to integrate this dl. Okay, now this dl, that is the small length of the current carrying element, we want to calculate magnetic field due to entire circular loop. So for entire circular loop, what we will do, we will integrate this dl to entire length. Okay, so what will be the length here? This is the circumference of this circular loop. Okay, so I am writing here, I am erasing this one. So integration of dB is equals to B mu naught upon 4 pi I and this r square, as it is integration of dl is 2 pi r, that is entire circumference of this circuit. Now you can see pi in the numerator, pi in denominator, 2 is here, 4 is here, so we can cancel out, r is here, 2 is here. So the magnetic field, because of this circular loop is B is equals to mu naught I divided by 2R. This is the magnetic field due to a circular current loop, and the direction of that magnetic field we can calculate with the help of right hand thumb rule. At any of the point we can calculate, here we can calculate, here we can calculate, at this point we can calculate magnetic field. Let's suppose current is going upwards. So if you put our right hand in such a way that this thumb is pointing in the direction of current, then what is happening? Here the magnetic field is coming out of this surface of the board or the page, okay? And at this point magnetic field is going inside, okay? So we can put our right hand at any of the point. Now this is for one loop only. If n number of loops are present, then what will be the modified derivation, that is modified magnetic field? Then it is mu naught multiply n I divided by 2R. This is for n loops. So in this way we can calculate magnetic field for n number of loops. This is the only loop, and the loops can, like, n number of loops can be made. Okay, so we can use this expression for n number of loops. So in this next video we will be using Biot-Savart law for any other derivations as well. Okay, thank you very much.